Yo, 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 what's good? What's up, family? What's up? We back here, man. Prolific Podcast, you know, again, keeping it fresh, bringing these hot, exclusive interviews to you with nothing but the best, nothing but the best people around. Today, I got two of my guys in here. Y'all know them from, they're doing a lot. So, I think I'm going to let them introduce themselves. They real heavy on the football world, both playing and coaching. So, nonetheless, man, we got my guy She here. We got my guy Kels here. What's good, y'all?
Yo, yo.
What's up?
What's good? So first of all, what I'm noticing, I'm seeing some seeing some different colors. I'm used to seeing black and gold. I'm kind of seeing some red hair. You know what I mean? Yeah, I mean, but first, we're going to get to that. But first of all, let the people introduce y'all. You know I mean? Let the people know who y'all are. Introduce yourself to them. Pull the mic up, bro. Remember, we did this last time. She, bro, you ain't new to this shit.
I've been down Blackhawks for about 3 years now. I was at Oakland before that, about 4 years up there. Coach 707. At the high school level, and I still play a little bit.
Modest. Here they go. We're going to touch down on this. They're doing this shit again, but we're going to touch down on it. But well, what's up, Kels? Talk to me, man. What's
Coach up, Kel? I've been down at the same time during COVID, came down. I was at Oak Lane before this. Before Oak Lane, I was coaching at Kutztown High School. Mm-hmm. I went to Kutztown University. I was coaching Kutztown High School for 2 years. That was probably my first coaching experience. But
how long ago was that? What year ago was that? When you start that, what year was that?
I was coaching at Kutztown in 2015. Okay. I graduated from Kutztown University in 17.
Cool. So you got a crazy amount of experience because y'all guys ain't really that old. Y'all still some young dogs in the game, and y'all really been doing this shit for a long time. So you say 2015, Kels, that's major. So you coached the youth level too as well. I think the first time I heard about you, I seen you was at the Oakland Wildcats. And shout out to them. How long you? What year you started with them?
So when I graduated in 17, mm-hmm. I came home and coached. It's like a position coach. The next year, it was my first year. And so that was probably 19.
Okay.
Was my first year actually being OC. I played against Reggie and Rock twice.
Oh, shit. Okay. So y'all got acquainted on some different shit.
Yeah. That.
I wasn't on that.
No, I was by myself that year.
I was on the 155. I lost in the chip that year.
With the big dogs, the older guys.
Yeah. That was a national championship team we lost to, though, so it's cool.
That's cool. So what's up, She? Introduce yourself, man. I know you from playing football yourself. A lot of these people probably don't know you're a fucking dog on that field, bro.
Yeah, so I went to college, played at Westchester for 2 years, played DB, played corner. After college, I tried a semi-pro route. It wasn't really entertaining, honestly. It was a waste of time to me. I got into a couple of my friends got me in the flag and I like fell in love with it.
All right.
Went out there. I played corner, played nickel. We got some younger kids came out. I moved down to start rushing. Anything to help the team.
He's a little modest again. I mean, I think he's a little camera shy. The dude is a national champion.
Yeah,
I mean, starting corner, starting safety, starting D line, starting linebacker, like a dude, he versatile. He can play a little bit of everything when it comes to the field. So I'm gonna give him his flowers and shout him out with that. Maybe y'all can come check him out. You know what I mean? Y'all can get it. Y'all own experience for yourself. Yeah,
don't let DJ be modest either. Me and him had some wars
yeah,
over here.
Yeah, yeah.
It's all the time.
It's a time for everything. It's a time for everything, man. But like I said, it's about you right now, bro. We definitely gonna talk about that shit. So we definitely got some wars and I mean, put some shows on the field against each other. But Just get to the red, man. That's my favorite color, but I don't think it's because of that. I don't think y'all wore red hair today because of me. Nah. Yeah, you know I mean, what's going on with that?
He played there, so I'm gonna let him. You
know what
I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I graduated.
So play where? Just make sure we know what we're talking about.
Talk about MOTEP. I graduated from MOTEP 2012. I played there for 2 years. Actually, was one of the captains of my team my senior year. Played there under Troy Gore and Mark Wilson the year before Albie and all them. The transition came in. And we just got the opportunity to go down there and help coach this upcoming year.
Oh, so y'all coaching there.
While we got it on.
Yeah. Thanks, Kel.
This year, I'll be OC for the JV team.
I'll be DC for
DC for JV team. And we'll help on varsity position coach.
I'll be assistant DB coach on varsity. And I think running backs, right?
Yeah.
All right. Just real quick, you that joint like just, yeah. Well, now pull us close to you.
Act like you've been here before.
Bro, I was.
I mean, that's all right, bro. That's shit. We'll get him right. So, man, that's a big opportunity, man. That's a big opportunity. Y'all guys coming into a position like that, y'all got an opportunity to be there for a while because y'all coaching kids that's 2 years removed at the youth level, at the Black Hawks. Y'all coaching kids that's 2 years removed from being in that position themselves. So y'all already had y'all hand in there. And I'm pretty sure with the grade of coaches you guys are, y'all going to have some kids that's going to follow y'all there. And that's going to serve, that's definitely going to serve as an advantage for y'all. How did that opportunity come about? Because that's a big deal. Imhotep finished like in the state championship for like the last 40 years. So, you know what I mean? That's just not nobody. They didn't invite anybody to be a part of that. You got to be a dog. Like, you got to be one of them ones to be able to grace the sideline with some of them greats that have been there. So talk about that opportunity. How y'all come about that?
It's actually crazy because Kenny actually reached out to us. Kenny was actually my coach my last year at the Wildcats. He coached me my last year. He actually reached out to Kel about talking to us.
Okay.
I didn't even really know about it at first.
At their championship game against West Philly.
not yet.
You mean the back-to-back one, right?
Just go ahead.
Not yet. Let's stay red and black right now.
I actually had two other offers this year for high school jobs.
He's ready to go. He's ready to go.
I actually had two other high school jobs this year offers.
Talk that shit.
I kind of wanted to – I had to give the home team the
– Yeah.
I got an offer from Northeast to be the DB and receiver coach there with their new coaching staff, and I also got offered by my old defensive coordinator when I was at Motep, Troy Gore, Showing.
That's a big deal. Shout out to Coach Troy, man. Kels, what's up, y'all? So y'all came as a package deal. Y'all guys, y'all running, you know what I mean? Y'all running the payment together, y'all running the fields. So was it a package deal? You got your own situation?
No, I mean, he had his own thing going on at first.
Okay.
I was in talks with like you said, with Kenny for a minute.
Yeah.
I always wanted to, I want to progress in coaching, like, period.
Yeah.
Like, not just Little League. I want
to get to the next level.
And, I mean, what other place better to go to at this, like, it's nothing really to question.
Definitely.
I mean.
And, yeah, as a standard.
I got standard. You.
And so, now, you're like, with your name, like, floating around in the sports world, in the youth sports world, has been one of the best OCs. Like, you've been crowned that by a few names that's from guys that's already, like, polished and, like, got put, like, groundwork down here. So that accolade is a big deal coming from them guys. So how long is it? Has it always been an offensive coordinator since you've been coaching? That's all?
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, cool.
For sure.
That's what's up, man. That's a big deal.
Even when I was at Kutztown, I mean, with them coaches out there, just steady film, all that.
Well, I'll tell you now. So people going to see this, they're going to hear this. Like, I've been hearing it. You're definitely going to have a target on you. People going to want to stop that offense that you got coming out, man. So I think you need to stay on your you know what I mean? Stay ready and clean this business up that you got coming up before you get to, before you get to Tep. Because there's some things that's going on here in this in the youth league.
I mean, I'm always trying to learn and, you know, progress and different things. I don't want to, you know, stay where I was at last year.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever you saw last year, don't think you're going to see it next year.
For sure.
We're going to keep adding to it.
For sure.
We're going to keep adding to it.
Sure. So what's some of these kids that's on the that just got the MOTEP? Because I have a few kids that played on my team. That's entering to play at MOTEP this year. So if they seeing this, they watching this as a coach, or you've been a new coach, what could they look forward to?
I'm straightforward.
Talk to all the weapons that's coming there, all the offensive weapons that you, these new cars that you get to drive.
Do what you do.
Yeah.
That's my whole thing. Do what you do. You gonna catch the ball? Catch the ball.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna put you in the place. I'm gonna put you in the best position possible.
That's what I'm talking about. Let them know.
Just do what you gotta do. Use your talent and do what you gotta do.
Yeah. So I know on the defensive side, you're gonna demand a lot. You're gonna be tough on them. You're gonna be stern. And I'm pretty sure a team follows their coach, the way they, you know what I mean, the way they play. And if they watched you play, if they know anything about you, they got to bring that shit.
That's kind of something we preach. Attitude come from the top. You're going to be a reflection of your coach.
Got you.
Reflection of the leader. So I'm going to just actually play hard, play physical, and know your assignments. You know where you're supposed to be. Let your talent take over the rest, like you said. Just be where you're supposed to be at. Natural ability to take over after that.
See, this high school,
yeah,
right? It's not Little League. In Little League, we're developing. You know, they might not know everything. They might not have everything perfected, like their actual craft. In high school, we rocking and rolling. You might start as a freshman on varsity.
Yeah.
I mean.
I let them know it's not easy.
Absolutely.
It's not easy. It's definitely not going to be given. So that's why I want to try to let these guys know when they come in, what should they expect when they come to practice, that first practice, when they get to know y'all, like, they should come on their shit, no games.
Come ask my young boys.
Yeah. And it's not about, right, so we're going to make sure they decipher the difference of youth Kel, Coach Kel, until, you know, to the next level of the big
boys. Anybody that plays with me, you're going to work.
Yeah.
I don't care who you are, what your name is, what your name was, what you were in Little League.
Got you.
You're going to work.
Got you. So I'm definitely going to pay attention a little more this year. I've said that last year, even when my team have, when we were still here last year, I said that Petra Pack was one of my favorite teams, or the favorite team down here when it comes to the Blackhawks. Like, when I want to watch, when I actually get a chance to sit back and enjoy a game, I actually like, you know what I mean, I like the way how y'all doing things. And I thought, man, who's this young boy? You know what I mean? What's the opportunity, where you come from? So I'm thinking you just a guy that's learning, you know what I mean, that's just there. I mean, probably rock young boy, but you really driving the ship, though. You know what I mean? You ain't somebody that just coming out here just holding the clipboard. You really them one of them ones on the sideline. Yeah? Just like
I
that.
I mean, I'm around.
I got you. So, shit, man, I ain't really, when we had the podcast before, when we was talking about at the Digga, you were kind of like lax, like laid back. You know what I mean? You definitely played a huge role when it come to them teams, man. So that's why I want to keep harping on that, because you're pretty much a laid back guy. So that's why I understand like how I got you here for a second episode, because you don't really seem like a guy that really like talk too much.
No, with that, I actually definitely was one of the front runners that like get that all that going. Like Bo told me that all the time. Bo talked to me like basically just gonna be my shit when he done.
Yeah,
like I'm gonna be one of the leaders of it. And I'm just ain't the loud type of guy. I just show up, do what I gotta do. As long as we winning, I'm cool. I don't need no spotlight, none of that. As long as the results is in our favor, I'm good.
That's cool. So y'all plan on playing at the Tep for a while? It's not nothing, just temporary. Mm-mm. This is a stint. This is something that we've been to
the state chip. How many years in a row?
Yeah, y'all. I've been there now. I've been there the last 2 years now. That's a big stage. As a big stage, and like I said, you coach in high school, and you've been on a big stage as far as playing, you know, at high school and, you know, at the flag national level. But I know that's a big stage. Y'all guys ready for that? The coaching goes to another level. The playing go to another level. Like the size of the guys, the athleticism. Like, I don't know. I mean, shit, again, you played there or whatever, but from the time I've been watching in the last 2 years, like, the competition gets a little better. The Tep always there. That's the thing. The Tep is always there.
Yeah.
I haven't yet to see a team. Yeah, you won on paper. I have yet to see a team that actually physically like beat them. Mm. Like make them look bad and know like you didn't think Tep was gonna win that game. So like them guys is really doing a great job with that program, and then bringing two guys like y'all on to help with that, man, is just gonna make their program a lot better and a lot stronger, man. So that's a shout out to them. So anything other than that, like any other plans y'all guys got going on? I know y'all still with the same youth way that you said
I'm one of the best right now, mm-hmm, at the Little League level. I plan on doing the same thing at the next level.
Yeah, cool.
I'm gonna get around, you know, somewhere.
Yeah.
Football minds,
people to learn from.
That's what's up. So is there any other plans? We're gonna touch down on the youth level. I don't mean far as that, but anything going on, any other trainings y'all guys got your hands in, any other thing else that these young boys should know about?
We both coach Philly's Finest 707.
The high school level.
So that's what we're doing right now. We about to 4 straight tournaments in the next month.
Yeah, I actually been on my last year team was we competed, but we just couldn't finish games. This year I'm trying actually win some tournaments, mm-hmm, make nationals this year, take the next level. I've been doing it for a couple of years now, so it's due time.
I got you. So Philly Finest, how long y'all been doing that?
Sheesh, I've been maybe 5-6 years now. I've been out there.
So I think the first time I seen you was like probably last year, or maybe the probably a year and a half ago with the scheme team. John, y'all guys, man, y'all got a big task on y'all hand. Like Tep is a big organization, man. So it's like, again, what I said before, they don't just let anybody like grace those sidelines. You know what I mean? So y'all guys got to be some good coaches, some great coaches.
Absolutely,
great coaches. You know what I mean? See, are we good today? We got my man in here right now. Huh? What's up? Yeah, I use great coaches. Am I allowed to use that today? Okay, cool. So let me recant that back. We got somebody in here. I mean, I think we all going to all know who it is. We're going to do some rapping later. But, you know what I mean? I'll let him get to that. And he's going to talk a little bit more about the MOTEP scene because he's on there. So he can give us a little more in-depth to help these modest, humble young brothers out. You know what I mean? Talk some things.
Basically, about what you said, like anybody can't get there. I think our resumes last couple of years kind of speak for itself. We ain't get offered the opportunity because I went there or because we cool with anybody. our resume speak for itself over the last couple of years. Right. Like he might have scored the most points in the last 2 years in the city.
Our That's defense, a fact.
Anybody that see our defense play know we got one of the fastest, most physical defenses in the country. Fuck the city, in the country.
You said so he scored more. I'm not gonna let that go by. You say he scored more points than anybody.
Yeah. Anybody.
Yeah, we could probably stamp that. Anybody in the city, and probably nobody throw the ball more than us in the city.
See, that's what I mean. See,
nobody developed in the passing game as much.
See, that's what the city needs to know. That's what they need to hear. They need to know what, you know, I mean, Coach Kells is bringing to the table.
We
need to
know real offense. Yeah. Like, we're not just catching and running and catching and going. Like,
yeah, is it like we got route concepts. We got blocking schemes. We got everything. It's just like
y'all guys is coaching. Let me help my gang out. They coaching over here. See, I try not to do that. You know what I mean? I got somebody got on me that's in the building. See, the accolades. I gotta be cautious on how I throw them out there, whatever. But I know these guys personally, whatever. So yeah, I mean, they out here. Yeah, I mean, really getting shit done. They not just coaching. They just not on the sideline. Some guys that's assistants. These guys are really putting these kids in the best positions to be better athletes on the next level. Because they're coaching at that level. They're coaching at that age. And as you see the hoodies that they got on, say best of the standard. Everybody knows about Imhotep. So y'all know can't just anybody walk through those doors. So that's a good testament to them, how the good things that they're doing and how they moving here in the city. So we kept touching down on that, like what you guys known for with the youth. I think we should go there. I think we should talk about that. You know what I mean? Congrats with the Imhotep. We're definitely gonna talk about that. And when y'all guys get y'all first experience, the Grace's sideline, and really get some games in, I want y'all to come back and tell the people y'all experience. I definitely wanna know. You know what I mean? I would love to coach the high schools ever one day. I had a few offers, a few, you know, conversations with somebody, but I just got a lot of things going on. And then with my son still at Imhotep with his last year, I wanna be able to enjoy that. So one day I'll be blessed with the opportunity. But again, I want y'all guys to come back here to talk to me about it. Let me know some things maybe I didn't know or I want to know. So again, I want to congratulate y'all. I gave y'all flowers on that because that's a big deal. Mm-hmm. I'm definitely proud of y'all about that. But let's go to the youth level. You guys coach the pressure pack. Right?
Wait, I think we have one more thing about Imhotep, right?
What's up?
You want to talk about Imhotep?
Who? Don't worry about it. This is my guy. I got him. He, you know what I mean? I got you, gang. We got time for that. We got time for that, bro. You know what I mean? I think he knows now. Rock with the everybody. Relax. You know what I mean? Can we coach this? So y'all guys coaching the pressure pack, man. A national team. Like, if they don't know now, they know them. Like, y'all didn't take no easy meals. It was nothing regular about last year. I talked to Coach Rock about the battle situation, the battle experience. I definitely want to talk to y'all guys about it, man, to get y'all experience learning about being younger coaches. I don't know if y'all coached at that level before, yeah, but with that level of competition.
Year before we was at EYF.
Yeah, but I don't think it was that level of competition that y'all saw.
Nothing is that level of battle.
All right, cool. So talk to the people about that. Was that your first time coaching against a caliber like talent like that?
Yeah, it's different. I ain't gonna. The speed is different. The way they prepare, the schemes, everything is just different. It's like some shit. It's some shit that we probably never seen before. I ain't gonna lie. Anybody in the city that think they there, when you ain't there, the shit is next level. Honestly,
anybody in the city.
Listen,
yeah, anybody.
Couldn't nobody go out there and do what we
do. Don't go there. Absolutely. Don't go there because you itching to go somewhere. You itching to talk about something. I just need you to chill. No, I just need you to chill.
Nobody in the city can do what we do.
I know. I got that. But I just want y'all to talk about this experience before we go there because we gonna go there. We're going to go there. You know, prolific podcast. Y'all know what we do. We keep this shit 300 up here. So we definitely going to go there.
The experience is just, you see some of the best players in the country, the best coaches in the country. You see the difference in the, like, kids talk, like parents and kids complain about, like, the depth of teams.
Mm-hmm.
We went down there shorthanded, first of all. We was missing some players.
Shorthanded.
Missing a game day when one of our probably best defensive players got sick. He couldn't play in the biggest game because no one was in the country.
He got
sick, couldn't play in one of the biggest games in the country. He's missing one of our starting DBs to play with us all year.
March. 700.
Missed another.
Kells is ready.
Yeah. Missed another key role player. Zayton would have been a great rotation guy for us down there. He didn't. He wasn't there.
Okay.
He was short-handed, but that's not an excuse for us.
But this is three starters. This is what I love.
We ain't looking at no excuses and shit like that.
This is what I love about the pressure pack because nobody knew that but y'all. The way y'all still play, the way y'all still carry.
You know why it's fine? Because the replacement, because Maj didn't come,
mm-hmm.
You know, his first year playing football.
Who's that?
It's name Mahaj. If you watched him,
that was his first year playing football.
That's heavy.
Watched him, you would have never knew that.
That's heavy.
When he get in the stance, he looked like he been playing as long as Basil on the other side. The motherfucker stepped up that way.
And where that come from? Coaching.
Coaching.
That's a great job, man. That's what I'm saying. That's what these folks
need
to know.
He was prepared all season. And he happened to be thrown in the fire in the biggest part of our season.
Okay.
And I would say he responded.
So what did you, before I get to you, Kels, Kishi, so what's the, tell me one thing about that experience that made you a better coach.
I would just say, like I said, the depth, rotation, and pinches and like the rotation, like packages and shit.
Mm-hmm.
They tell you a lot down there. Like packages and blocking schemes could tell you a lot down there.
So you really have
honestly, I don't think our defensive scheme was terrible at all. We just misplays.
Okay.
We would have put somebody in a position to make a play.
No, you can't play for him. You only can coach.
I can't play for you. Yeah. We just misplayed, honestly. It was our kid's first time being down there.
It's everybody's first experience. It's a first experience for everybody.
We came out hot. We came out hot as shit.
Yeah.
We had a kickoff return that happened, but defensively, I think we were fine. We was in position. We just misplayed.
I got you. Kels, what's up, bro? What's up, man? That's so here in the city, you know, in the regional era, you know, guys know you. You know what I mean? You was able to pull that crazy playbook out, you know, call some of the best plays to become one of the best OCs in the city. But you went down there. I know battle. I know you got, you know, I know you met a few of your makers down there. Whereas though the things that normally work for you easy was definitely a little more challenging down there. So talk about some of the things that pushed you.
We still had our way down there. We still had our way.
That's what I'm talking about. Let me know. I wasn't there. I had to watch. I mean, let me know.
I think our depth like came to bite us. And like against number one team in the country, we came out, we scored first.
Mm-hmm.
We go up. They kicked the ball off. I don't think they got the extra point. I think we still up.
We still up.
They came back. They scored. They stopped us. They came back. They scored. We scored again.
Got you.
Then they went down to score. We drive and score. We get a penalty.
Mm-hmm.
Penalty don't happen. We score that drive. We inside the 10.
I got you.
It was a 10-yard crackback penalty. It took us, went to second and fucking 30 damn near.
I got you. But, I mean, I think all this is within the swing of the game, man.
I understand
you putting it out there, but I don't want it to put no smut on, like, y'all effort that went down there. I like the fact that y'all went down there and rumbled for the first time and whatever's going to come
down there,
from that.
We didn't go down there just to go down there.
We don't go into shit.
I would go back and play SCD and go butt it tomorrow.
Absolutely. Not expecting to win.
So, long story short, y'all wasn't going down there to prepare to take second place.
I will never take second place.
I
would never let the referee do this. Ever. Ever. Ever.
Oh, shit, it's okay.
I don't care if you're the
number one team in the country.
I guarantee you any set of coaches that prepare more than us.
Got you.
That's guaranteed.
I got you. So
Nobody watch more film than these two motherfuckers.
Y'all say that with super confidence.
100%.
Okay, cool. So what's Kels, what you got planned, man? Like, what are you looking forward to get from your offense this year?
Oh, we're going to shake a lot of stuff up.
Yeah.
we're going to
school board
some
up.
Different things. And, bro, I don't stop watching film, bro.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm always trying to look and see what's the next, you know, next thing that we can do.
Got you.
These teams in the city ain't see half of nothing. We ran a whole nother, my play calling out against SED and Gold-Blooded, it's totally different in the city.
Got you.
I mean, I'm not even trying to be funny. I want them to get better.
Okay.
Like West Philly, 215.
Why you say West Philly first? Why you say, y'all heard it, it's not me. Why you say West Philly first, bro? So let's talk about that, man. Let's talk about that matchup. Let's talk about the matchup. Let's not bullshit. There's going to be some people that's going to be on this podcast that's going to watch, and they definitely going to want to know about that again. Because I had my guy up here, Rock. Mm-hmm. You know, he came up here, he was doing his job. He just, you know, starting off fresh, letting know what's going on with the pressure pack here in the city. But, you know what I mean? He ain't really.
Rock is a chill.
He's a chill dude.
Rock got a career. He got things going on.
Yeah, so.
He can't talk about certain things.
But we can.
Absolutely.
Okay. So let's talk about it. The matchup, again, that everybody talk. I'll give y'all guys a chance to, I want to say rebuttal to some things that was said. Because I know y'all you wasn't here. Kels was here. Kels was here at the interview, but he was chilling. He was doing his other thing. And we had Coach Sick come up here, a former opponent of y'all. You know, and she talked about some things that's going on with her. Shout out to her and all that. What we got into some talk about a certain championship that was played. And the captain of
Which
y'all.
One? Last year's championship.
That's your championship. We gonna get to that because I know. What is it?
No, uh-huh. Back to back. Good.
All right. Okay.
Good. There we go.
All right. So again, Rock said that, you know, he believed that she played for second place, that she didn't believe that she can win. And long story short, as we all saw, she took that some time, some kind of way.
Yeah.
And I want to give you guys an opportunity to know, I mean, to respond about that.
Yeah,
you know, so you know, Kels, let's be straight up, because I want to sit back. I want to let guys get the chance to say what they got to say. You know what I mean? Well, we got the opportunity here. Your offense was called boring. Mm. You know what I mean? Y'all only put up 14 points, and the Warriors are sick. What the fuck did y'all do? Like, you know what I mean? So talk about that, man. Because we talking about now, you giving your flowers and saying how good your offense is and so forth and so on. You know, but she felt a little different. She felt a little different in that game. So what was that? Is it a credit to her defense, or was it something that you were doing?
What defense?
I watched the game. I mean, it was a 14-6 ball game.
Yeah, that's not like they're a good.
When I wanted to go up top to Elam,
yeah,
what we do?
I got you. I tell them. I mean, we can talk all day. I was there, but talk to the folks that's here, that's watching and listening to the podcast. They need to know what happened.
So you watch our games in Florida, right?
Yeah,
we threw the ball.
Mm-hmm.
We a pass heavy team.
Yeah.
We throw the ball. How many times I throw the ball against them?
Not much.
Four.
All right.
One to Elam.
What's the why though? Why? Because I was given. So you know what? Let's do this right. This is a prolific fucking podcast. We're gonna do this right. We're gonna let my man. He's here. So we just gonna bring him in on the interview as well. I don't care if he don't want to. You know what I mean? This we here. My guy Rock is here. Coach Rock was good. You know what I mean? We're gonna get time to set. Let's reset the cameras in there to let the game. Let him move in. She move a little bit, bro. I got you.
Kel looks taller to me. I'm not feeling this. Goo.
Yeah.
So Rock, my man, Coach Rock, man. Coach Rock, he gave me. You can just turn it to you, like whenever you want to talk. Like, actually, move it up. I dealt with she and UT all night. I don't think they got that. Like, yeah. So, you gave me some slack about a few things that I said.
Yeah.
Right. Sure. I don't think I need to introduce you. Everybody know who Coach Rock is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean? You gave me some slack about a few things I said. Right. So we were just talking to Kels about the whole his offensive playing, offensive play call, whatever, and she addressed that it's only 14-6. Everybody knows it's only a 14-6 ball game. Mm-hmm. So we kind of gave her, not we, sick, they kind of gave, you know, they kind of gave you her slack about it. And her rebuttal was, you only put up 14 points as well. So I want to give you a chance to touch down on that, what you mean when you said she came for second place or whatever she was doing really wasn't that good, but you guys only won 14-6.
The main words you're using is one, that's first of all.
That's right. Fact.
I mean, 14. We was up 14 nothing at one point. She took it as disrespect. I'm just saying what it was. You let the ref count down every play. You know, we all know, like, everybody could tell he was playing not to get blown out. That's okay. What it is. I mean, to me, it was smart. It wasn't even really a dig. It was smart, okay. You know, game plan. You know, we don't have a team like they have or whatever, but they couldn't compete with us in a regular, you know, just getting out the huddle, snapping the ball. I thought it was smart, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. He tried to keep the ball away from us.
I think they completed a fake punt or something like that. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, yeah, so, you know, we had a lot of penalties go, you know, against us. But she made the game boring. I thought it was smart. It's not even really a dig. She made the game boring. She took the air out the game, and
she took that as kind of disrespect to say when y'all say that. She said that, like, it's no way that she would do that.
Well how it's, we say that? Like,
it's no that, like, she would actually come prepared to lose.
She, come on, bro.
This is what she says. Okay, hold, Kels. Let me,
she always lose.
Okay.
I mean, cosplay, like,
you think she always lose? Why you say that? I think she pretty. I say she's a good coach.
You was the one who made the statement.
Yeah, what did I say?
You said she's one of the best.
Right.
And I've been coaching for a while.
Okay.
And I don't know what we consider best. How many people could be one of the best?
I think she's successful, like, within her coaching period. I mean, she's won some games. We talked before. Mm-hmm. We talked previously for this interview, and you let me know it wasn't too many big games that she won.
No,
I mean, hold on. Let me answer you, bro. So, I mean, with her, how she moving from what I see. I haven't seen too many things like on the national level. I wasn't following her teams too much like that. But I know she was one of the first coaches that I seen that I think same thing I'm giving you guys kudos about playing at that national level.
No, she get kudos. She definitely went on the road.
Right. So again, so I want to make sure I gave her a love for that, because I had a lot of respect for her when it come to that. And hold on, and also like she it's not easy coaching. It looks easy when you're coaching a talented team, a team with a lot of talent, but you also got to make that work. Absolutely. You know what I mean? If she done that with like a lot of talent, she brought some talent to the table that I saw. She also developed some young men. So and that. To me, is respect and enough for me to give her that title. So now, I want you, my brother, I want you to say how you felt about that.
We respect all that.
Right.
Like, she carried when it comes to Young Bulls.
Mm-hmm.
She, you know, the kids love her. Right. And I respect like that 100%. Mm-hmm. But when it comes to football,
I don't see it. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Like, when you say one of the best, I've been doing this for a while, and resume speak for itself. A lot of other people's resume speak for themselves. I ain't seen her win no championships. Like, where she was winning that.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I know she won one down here, something like that. And like in all these big games, she was pioneer. She was one of, I think she probably was the first person to really hit the rule, mm-hmm. her and Keno. But you gotta win some of these games. Like, it's easy to say you was in the fight,
mm-hmm.
but you gotta win.
Right.
You ain't just out here just to be, say you sharing the field with somebody. You know what I'm saying?
I got you.
Like, when you say one of the best, I know some of the best.
Okay.
Derek, one of the best. Keno, one of the best. Hearn, one of the best.
That's a fact.
DJ, your resume speak loud.
Appreciate you, know what you,
saying?
Bro.
Like, it's a lot of, like, I'm trying to figure out when you say one of the best, what does that mean?
But that's what I was saying. Furthers her
Furthers
her success with the kids and player development and stuff like that.
I don't know about player development. I coach the team she coached, so I can't give you that.
Okay.
I mean,
you would know. I mean, we
the kids was talented for sure.
Absolutely.
That group of kids talented.
So they still needed some coaching up.
I coached the team. I got a team after she got them, so I don't see the development part. I didn't see a lot of well-polished kids.
Gotcha.
I seen a lot of talented kids. I mean, that we had to fix a lot of back pedals and stances and releases, all that cool stuff.
Okay.
I mean, so I don't see when you say best, I don't like when people throw, we use words too loosely. A lot of people earned a lot of credit and respect putting work in this game, and we kind of just throw that around. There's a lot of up-and-coming guys like Akella Shee. There's a few other guys in different organizations that I'd be like, yo, they get the best stamp before other people get it.
I got you.
You know what I'm saying? Like, we got to stop throwing, like, resumes matter. You know what I'm saying?
But you know, everybody's opinion would be different, though.
That's why I said, let's go black and white.
Okay, cool. So that's what you rating yours on, of the black and white. I'm just rating off the things that I see, you know what I mean? That, like, right. Of a respect level. You know what I mean? I can pretty much pay attention. I mean, now I'm doing this, I'm going to pay attention to a lot of things much more closely. You know, when we're more of the interviews and post game and stuff like that. So I got to do my homework to know what I'm, you know what I mean, really, really, really talking about. But I was giving her respect. I do respect her as a coach, and I do think she's a good coach.
That's fine.
I think that's good. I'm pretty sure we don't debate about much.
Yeah,
you know, especially when it comes to the football level. I definitely come to you when I need some advice and things like that. So I definitely respect what you're saying, but I definitely think she's a good coach.
That's fine. Like, I'm not mad at that. Definitely. I'm saying when you talk about football, X and O's development, she's great for what she do with the Sick Bowl. She's great for I don't know nothing else, but her plan.
She coached the DBs at Northeast as well.
What does that mean?
I'm pitting her accolades. I'm just saying she coached.
That don't make you good.
I'm just saying, man. She's proven that she can coach on another level. And I don't think is that an easy job to get? She being a DB coach.
No, but I did just get offered that job.
Oh yeah, can I speak on that real quick? So as everybody know, I'm the athletic director at MOTEP. These guys at MOTEP has nothing to do with me. I didn't say, yo, they got to come on or bring them on and nothing.
I thought that.
A lot of people going to think that. That's why I wanted to make it clear. It has nothing to do with me.
I respect them as coaches and players. Like I said, personally with Sheed, I went to war with Sheed many a times. So I know, you know what I mean, what he brings to the table. And then with Kel's, his resume, and the things that he's doing, the respect that he's earned from me and others. So I know that it had to be them. But I just know with you being there, you being one of the big dogs in the program, maybe it could have been a push. But the fact that you letting the folks know, that's better for them.
Nothing.
That's better for them. That's more respect given for them.
I mean, they earned it. They came down here, put the work in. Kel became one of the best OCs. He came in one of the best DCs and D-back coaches. But, you know, that's about it.
Man, listen, man. Y'all guys is Fuck. So what's up with this matchup this year? Y'all guys are gonna have to play them again. I guess West Philly.
Let's talk about that. Like everybody be trying to make it a rivalry, and
it's not a rivalry. But what my thing is,
rivalries can't be.
My thing is, it's two powerhouses, and I'm gonna correct. Okay, listen, hold. I got you. Let me correct myself because my dog, he got a little irritated with me, right? So when I say a powerhouse, right, I'm still gonna give the West Philly the respect that I believe they deserve. When I meant power, I was talking about
shout from out what the I West know. Philly teams that won a championship this year, respected them. I mean, a few coaches that watch Philly held it down.
Okay.
I mean, you can't be a powerhouse team and you can't win in your city. You can't be a powerhouse team.
I mean,
you can't be a powerhouse team and you go to the fifth best national championship.
Kev, move over just a little bit for me, Kev. I'm like toward that way. Rock, move in.
I kind of want to speak on something like said we was 0-4 down Florida.
You messed my question up. Don't let him court this, bro. Let me ask you a question, because I'm about to get to that. Because some folks was like, the shit was funny.
It was facts,
right? The shit was funny, and it was facts, right?
It was presented well. It was presented well. I didn't like it, but it was presented well.
So let's talk about that, though. What is the struggles? What is up with y'all guys? Why does she think? Because I believe that y'all can get it done. I believe y'all will get it done. But why does she and others in her eyes that liked the comment, that reposted it, why do they think you guys can't get it done in Florida? Like, what is going on? Why are we 0-4 in Florida?
Probably got a bunch of lights because it was presented very well. it was funny. But it's facts. We're 0-4. I mean, everybody know we went to AYF last year, somewhere she's never been because of us. We went 0-2. We lost the first game to PNB, a team we beat this year.
Mm-hmm.
In the second game, a lot of people don't know we sat half our team
for I know.
So in this year, we went to battle. A lot of people don't know.
Nobody else ever been
a place that nobody else been, and we lost in the regional championship, missed a game winning kick. We was able to compete in the regional championship because we won our city championship, and they didn't go to AYF because of us.
We competed against a team that this group of kids never was in a close game with until we got here. We ain't looking for no flowers and no shit like that, but ain't nobody like.
Yeah, like, so.
She said
so
her.
We are 0-4 in Florida, right? And they won a national championship, right? For whatever it's worth.
Yeah.
It's different when you're playing on Madden.
What?
I remember when you're playing on Madden, you're playing on rookie. Like not one of them teams. I'm just calling a spade. Like, and don't get it wrong. This ain't no shot at none of the kids. It's not a shot at none of the kids. I like the players on that team. I swear I do. We didn't even know we was going to go to region. For a fact, I called Ty before we went to region. I said, yo, we may just go battle. We might never go to region. I said, so have your team prepared.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I called West Philly and said, yo, just have your team prepared. We might not even go battle.
Speaking about who's going to go battle, about the favor we had to call in, we had that invite.
Mm-hmm.
So it was a
rumor that y'all had to call a favor in?
Yeah, like we ain't call.
What favor would y'all have to be called? Because you're already playing these guys. People already know who y'all are. They already showing that y'all can play on that level. So what would be the favor?
I don't understand that. A lot of people come up here and just create narratives and just sit here and people just going to take it and run with it.
Right.
Don't mean it's true.
I got you.
Everybody know us to be down here.
I feel like we challenge ourselves a little bit differently. You know what I'm saying? We went battle D1. We had D2 offer on the table too.
Mm-hmm.
And some of our parents, like, yo, why we ain't going D2?
Why do y'all think they didn't go battle? Or they
who?
Who? Oh,
you
gonna flip me on me.
Nobody else had opportunity. No, like they didn't have opportunity.
Why they ain't calling
No. Why they ain't like people been chasing for years.
If West Philly was presented the opportunity. If it's in it, I'm gonna get to that. If West Philly was presented the opportunity to play
they wouldn't be.
Everybody don't get that.
They wouldn't be.
Would you think they would?
No, 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 no.
She probably would go.
She probably. You know what? I don't know.
Okay. Absolutely.
I don't know because it's five. It's multiple national championships.
She don't turn away from playing nobody. I'll give her that. She don't turn away from playing nobody. I absolutely think she will go down there and play.
Maybe, I don't know.
She's fired, bro.
That's fine. But yeah.
Her 9 years, she wanted to play 30 games.
I want, there's a lot of stuff I want that I can't get.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
that was crazy. I heard that shit. I didn't.
Somebody played 30 games.
That was crazy.
Or 9 years, somebody played 30 games.
Yeah, she. That was. See what I mean, Rock? So it's shit like that. That's not easy, bro.
It's not easy. It's easy.
It's easy to play anybody.
And I think the fact. Yeah, she they definitely struggled. Yeah,
lost
they definitely
more games than any team in Blackhawk history.
Yeah. We got a bunch of bikes back last year. I ain't gonna lie.
I'm probably taking
things
at my kids.
We definitely like.
I love my kids.
Absolutely.
So last year, when the interviewer said, she said she's tired of her kids going to being like losing in Florida, getting embarrassed. Uh-huh. You know what I mean? That was her first time. I tried to give her flowers before and speak on the success and the things that she did with the kids, and she normally try to deflect it. You know, I'm just a coach, and I would just playing a role, and you know what I mean? That's them, that's their playing and doing what they doing, whatever. But that was the first time I actually heard her, to me, like claim them and like show, like really show that they, like she still has some love there. I mean, although I know she always will have love with them, but this is like one of the first times she actually, yeah, that's the first time when she actually, that I remember her actually talking like that. So speak to that though, like as if you guys, y'all, do y'all go down there preparing to lose? And like, so why does she say she's tired of her kids, you know, getting embarrassed?
We don't
so what do we say
AAU
about that?
Or what's the other, or D1, we don't go to them type things.
That shot's fired.
Or UIFL. Okay. Who's that battle, bro?
Okay, so is the difference?
Only AAU respect is basketball. Being honest. AAU ain't no football.
Bro.
And when we went, we used the same guys that we used all year. The same roster that was playing with us all year. When a million kids and people reached out to go to battle, we don't do that. That ain't what we do. You know what I'm saying? So we went to war with the same guys that started with us.
Got you.
I mean, so.
Yeah, Cal, I mean, Cal's on fire.
It's levels.
Talk that to him. Let him know what's up. Talk to him right there, bro. Talk to him. Let him know what levels we're on.
We going to go and do what we do. Because just like Tet, we the standard. We the standard in the city.
Mm-hmm.
We
but he's not okay with that, though. Who? He don't want to be. Rock wanted to be the standard pair up the East Coast. If I would have told him in the last interview that we were the best in the stand on the city, nah, man. You know, I don't want that. I ain't cool with that. I want more. Like, you know what I mean? So we just letting us know that that's our stomping ground, or we not settled with that, right? We want more, right? Because, again, we were just talking about the Florida shit. Like, are we going to catch? Let me put you on the spot right now. As a fan, as a fellow brother and a coach here with BH, are we bringing home some hardware? Will our success at least be more different than it is this year down Florida? Because I know that we're going. That's no mistaking. We're going. I'm saying it. I'm putting it out there. Even if these motherfuckers try to play the modest role like they always do, you know what I mean. But I'm putting it out there now. Like I said, that's my guys.
We're gonna be there again.
Yeah, we definitely be back. We be back down there. You know what I mean, like, and the reality is, I'm be honest, we going battle.
Period.
So
we going AAU and we going D1.
You trying to make sure nobody win nothing around here. Nah, so we going. So the thing is, we going battle. But what I'm gonna sit here with a straight face and tell you we gonna go win the battle championship? I can't do that. Mm-hmm. I mean, we gonna grind and work and make sure. And we got a few more pieces that's coming through. Yeah. So
it will be better.
We better. And people don't understand, like, going to Florida, you kind of gotta know what to expect, like. Even with this little subtle rule changes that was at battle, it was like, damn, we wasn't fully prepared for battle.
Oh, man. You know what I'm saying? Southern hospitality was different for me, baby. Yeah, Southern was heavy.
Southern was here, then you had battle.
So that's crazy. So that's scary. That's scary. You know what? It's not. Because Duval, we ran against Duval, and they serenaded us. They got us pretty good, but I seen them get their ass kicked, and I had a crazy respect for them. I'm thinking they were top tier, and them guys like Falcons United, shout out to all them guys that I've communicated with or whatever. But I thought like they were like were the ones, but they pretty much got their ass kicked when it come to in that battle shit.
Everybody
that was different.
We lost to this year was down Florida.
Absolutely.
At AY for battle. And Southfield won that.
Southfield won national championship. We lost by
a touchdown.
Touchdown.
And people don't know we got down to the 20-yard line at the end of the game. But yo, I didn't realize. So like even we took 5 losses this year. Mm-hmm.
Longhorns,
and we went back and beat them. Yeah. They was
that was, that was all it.
Yeah,
that,
I mean
that was all it to go back down there. We went down there and now y'all got to come back here to our game. No, I said no. We coming back.
He gave me
opportunity. We be back there. We gonna come back there and get that bike back.
Play y'all again. He said, "Well, come down here." We down there that weekend. Lost to Southfield, who's AYF champion. Who else we lose to?
City Life.
Lost to City Life. Everybody see that was, I mean, that was one of the best games we've seen in a long time. Right. We went for the game winning field goal, missed. I mean, got blocked or whatever.
How do y'all get y'all fan, y'all parents to be down with that? Because y'all do a lot of like traveling. The uniforms is crazy. The shit's not cheap. You think these trips are cost consuming? Yeah. Shout out to Skeen for sure. These trips is cost consuming. It's time consuming. And y'all have a family. Like, it's really a caravan that takes these rides with y'all up and
believe
down.
Not,
even if, like, some people that's not even parents that take these rides to come watch y'all play or whatever. Talk, like, what's the secret, man? What's the secret to getting these parents to follow y'all, you know what I mean, believe in y'all, whatever y'all want to do?
I think that's the word he used. Go back to that word, believe. I think they start.
The believe is different. They sit here. They sit over the last few years, and they see, like, how things are ran differently now. They just, it's easier to fall in line when you trust in something, when you see the results of it. When you see them, when you see the process that's going on the field, you like, damn. Like, I like the.
You trailing back from the mic, bro.
I like the direction they're going, and I like the process that they're going through. It's like, if you see something, you believe in it.
Yeah, well, that's a big deal,
and
man.
Our team is close knit. Like, the fam, the parents, the kids. Like, people don't, like.
But I know that even when they get to a certain age, I'm speaking from experience, you coached up there at that age too. You know that the participation dwells in youth league and youth sports as the time goes.
Parents more than I talk to anybody. Yeah, like yo, right? They like, you know, like, it's like, yeah, every day, right? We waking up to
we take. just dropped one of my kids off.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we
our kids are literally with us all the time.
We with them on a regular. I mean, the parents trust us. So trust us.
All right, cool. That's what's up, man. I want to. So let's get back to that, because again, I got some slack from that interview. So is any, you know what I mean?
Right. Interview.
The sick interview.
Oh.
Yeah, the sick interview when she came up here. You know what I mean?
Sure, we're on the same page.
Yeah. I mean, come on, man. He already said the city ain't got too much for y'all. Y'all ain't got too much for the city, so. It's only could be one form of the opponent. I don't want to make it personal. Like she said, rivals are not one side. I got that and I respect that. But there is no other. You know, I know you don't think they're a formidable opponent.
No, what I'm saying is, see, that's disrespectful. So you're being disrespectful again to people.
What?
Because what I'm saying is,
nobody's beating y'all.
No,
nobody here in the city's beating them.
But you made it a 2-team race. Like, we ain't going that the team we beat in the championship won in overtime the week before.
Okay. So
like, so it's I'm gonna give 215 Falcons in the third team in there, because they could be in the championship. They ain't going to beat them. We beat them off like 40 last year. But they going to still, but I'm saying they got a chance to be around to play us.
Yeah.
I'm not saying, we know they ain't going to win, but they got a chance to be around the players. They
around
might,
where?
They might make it to the championship.
They first game against them was 6-0, and the second game.
Around where?
They going to be around Germantown, better players. They going to be around the scoreboard, not like that.
Yeah, around like.
They got a chance to beat West Philly got a chance to beat them. Them two teams was that close.
That's the rivalry.
That's the championship will be Blackhawks and Panthers.
It's Blackhawks and somebody else.
I can't say that.
I mean, it may be.
Okay, so
I do think the Panthers have the better.
Okay,
the Panthers have the better players.
Okay, this is no disrespect. I mean, this is me watching the teams and stuff like that. She even attested it. About the 12U division and PA Elite. It's really not that competitive.
No.
You know what I mean? So again, it's no disrespect to anybody. I'm just going off simply just a sports analogy. I'm just things I'm watching. I don't really know too many competitive like 12U teams.
So
as of right now, so that's just my pick. I didn't say there's nobody else is able to make it. I got a chance. I believe it's going to be BH and West Philly. Just his period. And I think we all know that. Rox is doing the modest shit again. He's doing the AD shit again. He's doing the AD shit again.
He said probably 8-9, you probably will be.
Huh?
He said probably 8-9, you probably will be.
We really may play them. It's not guaranteed.
Y'all are going to play them.
But the competition is why we did what we did last year, though. Mm-hmm. We had games on Saturday and Sunday.
Right.
We played PME, Maryland Heat, DMV.
First year of being PME last year.
We was playing games dinner every Sunday, Saturday and Sunday. We knew we wasn't going to, we was already preparing for battle. All
right.
We knew we wasn't going to be prepared playing.
Beginning of last year, going into it, Rock said we're going to get a battle invite this year.
Bottom line.
Ben. But we said nobody ever did it before. We're going to do it.
Frankfurt Chargers, South Philly, West Philly, 215. That wasn't going to prepare us.
Okay.
So we had to go outside. And play them teams.
Okay, so Rock.
The schedule this year?
Yeah. It's crazy.
So we thought we was prepared when we went down there last year.
Mm-hmm.
And we played some teams last year. This year.
So, Okay, I got you. That's love. So, Rock, with you being one of the big dogs and being accomplished in this youth world, it's many. You definitely hearing a lot of hits, but right now, in the youth level, is that the way to go? Do you recommend other coaches take that route to become better? Because we just like the third interview I had when I got a coach, third, fourth interview, with coach telling me that the city really is really not that good and they got to go out of the city for competition. So, Ben, so you've been there. Speak to a couple coaches, a couple 12U coaches or 11U or whatever that might be watching. Like, what can a city do to get competitive again?
So,
like, what do you recommend?
This is the reality. This might not be the most popular opinion amongst people. It's like, the city ain't never going to be competitive. And the reason being, because of nationals, everybody
never?
Wants, no, never. Because everybody wants nationals. So, I got to look at the one or two teams that got a chance to get me there. So, I'm going there. I'm not leaving here. I'm not going to be there. It ain't never going to be a bunch of really good teams in one place. It can't be. If dudes are really trying to win nationals.
So, you think, is that the lack of talent in our city?
Well,
I mean, could you think about it, right? So, I mean, what else would be the reason why it's not a shitload of talent?
Because it's no city that's competitive, though. It's no city that you look at. Who?
Florida?
Florida's a state.
Georgia? I mean,
so, you know what I'm saying? It's no. I'm saying people that's close by, okay. Most of the best players are going to one place or two places. And so you might have two teams that rival each other, but it ain't going to never be four or five. That's over. That wave over. Yeah, nationals.
If you look across the country, we just had, what's the team in Texas that just combined? Like the three teams that just
Fort Zoo.
Zoo, Peck Prom, and the Bills.
And RCU combined with the team that they lost to.
Like, RCU won a national championship and combined with the team that beat them.
Southfield won a national championship last year and just combined with
combined.
Right. We are behind. So basically in the city, we're behind with that.
The way they do it, like, if you want to compare it, we would have kids from Pottstown, Reading, Allentown, Lancaster. Like, that's how it is. Hey, you go to Georgia,
right.
It's not Atlanta kids.
Yeah, they got kids from Florida, North Carolina, South Carolina.
I got you.
Everything surrounding autumn. We don't have the bomb, the super teams that everybody really be thinking of.
Rocking this B. Marshall shit right now.
Our kids, Basil, Dries, they been Blackhawks before that team was put together. Yeah. They Blackhawks kids, North Philly kids. Right. That wasn't a super team put together. Mm-hmm. They been Blackhawks. They black and yellow.
Got you. I got you, man. So anything. So I say again, man, before we get out of here, is it anything that we want to touch down on? Like, is it anything? Any questions y'all guys want to ask me? Anything I missed or something that y'all want to address? I know we had some.
I do want to say something. Like, about the shit talking. Like, everybody take it, like, to the next level. Like shit is personal. Like, at the end of the day, we're coaching youth football. This shit is not personal. We talk shit and that's what we do. That's what we talk shit
to each other all the time.
All day long.
If you go lose a game next year, I'm going to talk shit to you.
Motherfucker.
That's a good point, because even in, like, the last interview, I don't mess the mic up. The last interview, Sick made a statement, said, "Why are we worried about them?"
Yeah.
I don't know what she talking about.
I was there.
I asked her about that.
Exactly. I'm saying, what she talking about? Sorry,
like, I know exactly the situation that happened. We was at the 13U game, y'all against South Philly. We was walking around looking for one of the coaches because we was talking shit before the game, like we usually do. And a couple of parents walked up, said something to us. They said, "Why y'all ducking us?" So we like, what you mean? Why y'all ducking? Y'all ducking us? Friendly conversation. We just start going back and just shit talking.
Mm-hmm.
It wasn't nothing personal. It wasn't nothing like, we wasn't taking it there. We don't do none of that. It ain't
got you.
Shit, nothing personal with us. We gonna talk shit. Because that's what we do. We talk shit to 215. We talk shit to Frankfurt. We talk shit to anybody that's going. That's on our schedule. We gonna talk shit to you. Don't take this shit.
My personal. Staff talk
don't
shit.
Go next level. He start
pressure.
But we ain't concerned with. It was never like we was concerned with anybody in the city at all. That was never. I mean, of course, I always want to win a city championship.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I respect the city. I think you have to take care of home before anything.
Thank you.
So,
thank you.
We're not prepared to go to another national right now. Like, we're not trying to go AAU or D1 right now. A lot of motherfuckers they play. They already got plane tickets booked to there for something
when you,
different.
Like, when you get your schedule in the beginning of the year, it say like AAU nationals at the bottom.
Okay.
Already, hard joint say like AYF or battle. That's what we stand for.
All right, man. So again, Rock, what's up, man? Talk to me, bro. I want no beef. Did we clear our beef up today? Are we cool? Are we bad guys now today?
Oh, turn the bottom.
Don't worry about it. Listen, like she was just saying, none of this shit is personal. We don't get emotional over this shit.
She said she can do this shit back and forth, whatever. She just don't want it to get. She don't like when guys, some guys take it personal. And I do understand what she meant by that. That some guys like they do.
I understand. She's a female. I know that. I'm not trying to drag it into it, bro. They more emotional than us.
Oh my god.
I'm saying though, I'm serious. We never gonna be. It's never personal.
I get it, but yeah.
Don't bring your emotions into
it. Like, we're gonna look into the camera right now. Nothing is personal with us. We're gonna talk shit.
That was
I had to get back on that. Like, we're gonna talk shit. We're gonna do what we do, but it's nothing besides you football. So, anybody that think it's more than that,
not even just not. Her. Anybody.
Just go to anybody. Because okay. We
going to talk our shit.
Because we talk shit to any and everybody.
I like to have fun.
Gotcha.
When Keno, if anybody lose down here, when Keno lost two years ago, we talk shit. We talk shit to him because the first thing, when we first came down, the first thing Keno said to me, the hardest thing about being a Blackhawk is when you, the next day after practice and you the only motherfucker to lose.
Oh my God.
The only motherfucker to lose.
Oh my God.
And that's supposed to be going that. That's really the expectation. Like, the expectation you're supposed to win. So when you lose, it's a lonely place. You know what I'm saying?
Should I get called to the fucking
hall? I guarantee you. Rock, come on. Come on. I guarantee you, Rock probably be the first motherfucker to say something to you.
Oh, yeah.
Now, Rock got a look. He got a, like, some that. Little, like, he fucks with you. When they give you some open-ended shit, then they walk off.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But no, like, we got big goals this year.
We speaking on pressure. Pressure pack.
I want to speak on the Blackhawks as a whole. Blackhawks got big goals. And we operate a certain way for a reason. Like, that's why we kind of certain conversations, like teams. And this is my team. That's their team. I don't have a team. I have the team I'm coaching.
Mm-hmm.
And at the end of the year, either the board feel like we should be moving up or going a different direction. Like, nobody is supposed to coach a certain team, no matter what. Nobody can move up. You've been here long enough. It's teams that I want to coach. Like, yo, I want to move up. And we're like,
if you ain't producing, you're not going to stay with your team.
What?
If you're not producing, you're not going to stay with your team.
Who said y'all stole somebody's team?
It's not just that, though.
Who said y'all stole somebody's team?
No, I'm saying that was the narrative that this team was stole from. I'm saying that was the narrative for everybody, right? I know she kind of spoke on it, but that was the ongoing story.
She kind of said she put the team together. We took it from her. That wasn't like a.
She said that?
No, I gotta go. I'm not saying she. I'm saying that was the ongoing story that's been ran okay. for years. It was somebody said the other day on live. Mm-hmm. Like, that was a story that's been going on for years, and it never really been properly addressed. Everybody knew after 9U year, she wasn't moving up with this team. Everybody knew that.
I got the information afterwards. It was supposed to be like a 2-year thing.
It was,
and she was aware of that. So mm-hmm. so that I heard. Okay, cool.
And hold on, let me see.
That's not a surprise.
I'd even better. I was even going to add it to our staff.
I ain't got no flex. Boom. Like,
no,
flex. I got to get that shit. I got to get the flex bomb.
Happened,
yeah.
She was offered the 6U job and still be a part of our staff.
Why didn't that happen?
I don't know.
Was it up to her or some other decisions that made?
Completely. We didn't kick out. Like, we ain't, Blackhawks was like.
Damn, I wish I would have known it.
Like, she decided to do what's best for her. A few kids went with her in the process. So, like, it still was never nothing personal.
They came back.
I mean, it was never nothing.
I like this. I
don't
shit.
Like, people try to create the narrative. I said on last time I was here. It's no. I don't get into all that stuff with the storylines. So I don't know where all the personal stuff really came from, but it really ain't that. I mean, my issue is strictly football.
Mm.
You called her one of the best. I just disagree. I coach around a lot of the best, and that's kind of all I stand on. Like, but as far as the person, it's not personal. I don't hate the girl. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, we football competitors.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, but resumes matter.
Talk.
Resumes matter. And You got to start, when you have these people up here, mm-hmm. you got to get like a fine comb and start going through people's resumes. You can't just be standing. That's what we're doing. Prolific prep, when you want to come up here, bring your resume. There we go. And then you can hold people accountable.
I got you. Yeah,
instead of me got to sit back here and watch them
and dissect some shit. I got you.
You come up here a lot. That's what they've been doing.
I got you. I'm
creating on there.
That's all I got.
I'm gonna start checking some shit. But yeah, man, I appreciate y'all dudes coming up here, man. Like I said, I appreciate.
I just want to speak on, like, coming from Oak Lane, coming here, like the differences. Like I love Oak Lane. Grew up Oak Lane, blue and white. That's my shit. But like coming down here, and like the differences, and like the support you get, like the support you get, that like the X's and O's. I look at the game a completely different way now.
Mm-hmm.
And Rock
saved him.
Beach, baby.
Like I said, he made me look at the game a different way, especially on the defensive aspect of the game.
Yeah, I took a Rock there. I learned some shit from him just by watching on the sideline one that particular game. So I definitely could believe that.
Definitely, like, learned, as a testament to my coaching career so far, mm-hmm. this has made me grow like light years.
Cool, man. That's what's up.
Attention to detail.
Yeah. Facts. I see you big on that.
No. Kel, give me credit.
No, I'm not.
Hey, that's what's up. So is anything, Rock? Come on, bro. I want no more dirty looks since we cool now. I
just wanted to address.
Okay.
When you made a statement, I just wanted you to stand on your statement.
I think I did. We got an understanding. Do we got an understanding at least? And that, although we disagree, but do we got an understanding of where I came from?
A better understanding.
This guy, man.
I mean, I just respect the game. And mm-hmm. I just want that respected at all times.
I got you. Cool. So, Kels, what's up, bro? Top OC, top dog in this joint right now, man. Before we get out of here, bro, what's going on, man? Let these D coordinators know, man. Should they get some sleeping pills the night before they play against y'all? Because they ain't going to be able to sleep. They got so much shit to worry about.
Prepare.
Yeah.
Prepare. Prepare right. better. Be better prepare coaches. Better. It's not the kids.
Because you're going to be.
It's not the kids' fault.
Right.
The 40, the 38 we put against 215, even the 14 that we put against West Philly. Y'all getting 40 this year.
She said that. So we was talking about that. And I asked her. I said, what y'all going to win by? She like, she's going to score the same 40 that y'all scored. The same 40 that y'all supposed to score. Listen, that shit was funny. Where did that come from? Who said that? What happened?
In three games.
I'll tell you what happened.
Can I say one thing that they're going to score in three games?
Okay, so what's the total?
I'm 3-0 against them.
I heard some people, like somebody, in particular coach here made a post at interview, and they had a record on it. How many
55
points?
55-7, 0-3.
And who was
that's
that?
Like two who point something points a game.
Who was we talking about?
Talk about them. Talk about them.
West Philly Panthers.
So they only scored 7 points in.
The 0-4, and we only scored 14. You scored 6. You scored 7 in 3 games.
Seven? Three games?
It was
2 points. So is this your gripe towards me?
What didn't sit right with me was to prepare better.
So because it's only 7-3 games?
Yeah.
Is that your gripe towards me?
I don't have moral victories.
Okay.
I don't have moral victories. Either you win or you lose.
Gotcha.
However it happens, you win or you lose. So, I mean, you only score 14 points, but you left with the trophy. Sound crazy to me.
I got you.
I mean, literally. I expected to win by 40. Uh-huh. I did. We fuck the money up. we did, but at the same time, I think that was a moral victory for other people. I don't care what it is. If you don't see me no championship pictures after the game, I was pissed.
At what, the score?
Yeah.
So I wanted to ask Kels that, but we got cut off. We started talking about something else. What was that? What was that about, bro? What was that about? Because a lot of people felt that part of her interview. And so, it kind of dropped some gems. Like,
I'm not here.
What's up with that?
I still got a trophy. Trophy at the crib.
I got you.
But so back to back, both of them.
Mm-hmm.
But
was it?
No, I don't have neither one.
I got
them.
One.
So
but
what
I'm saying
was, they, was they both against? Was they both against West Philly?
Yeah,
it was 14.
Okay, cool. So
14-0 one year, 14-7.
Let's talk about. Let's get to that before we get out of. Let's get to that 40. The 40 ball that didn't happen to turn to 14. What was that about? Was that something that y'all or was her defense?
I'm gonna explain everything.
So this
is this what we don't? Okay, I got it now. One, I got it now. I understand now.
Go 10.
I understand it now. Okay, cool.
But I'm gonna tell you this though. If you was at the game,
yes, sir. On the field,
went first touchdown.
Yeah,
went up top. Elam, single covered.
Dude is a beast.
That was a bad game plan. If I
shout out to you for the Elam drop. Cause Rock said, like, I mean, how you made the call in? That's heavy for the program. Shout out to that.
Not even Elam. we had a even a second drive, we had a miscommunication between me, my quarterback, and receiver, mm-hmm. right? Maj. Yeah. If it was communicated right,
touchdown.
It would have been another touchdown.
Gotcha.
We threw the ball four times, right? We're a passing team. Mm-hmm. That's what we do. Our pass opened up our run. That's what we do.
I got you.
We threw the ball four times.
So it was our doing. It was the Blackhawk thing. It wasn't too much of anything she was doing.
Being young and dumb, I guess, I was preparing for the next week. We play City Life next week.
It's not young and dumb.
And we had a touchdown call back.
Mm-hmm. Well, we was playing City Life next week. I was, you know, trying to establish. So preparing for City Life, they have an explosive offense. Mm-hmm. So as an offensive coordinator, I still got to think about
understand
our defense. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to, you know, not give them too many possessions.
Gotcha.
So me going into, you know, we down 11th Street. Mm-hmm. You get talks from a lot of good coaches. Somebody mentioned to me to, you know, not get caught up in the hype and
just get the next week.
I got you. We spoke about that off. Okay, I got you. I see where you're going at now.
So me going to the game, I'm trying to, you know, establish our run. Milk the clock.
So you basically got caught into working on something. You chose to flip the narrative and say, you know, she ain't really playing to win. She just playing the clock. So when we do get the possessions, we're gonna work on them. We're gonna take advantage of those. So those am I correct here? I don't want nobody to. I'm correct on that.
Stay in the moment.
I got you. Okay, cool. So I think I learned from it though.
Yeah.
Definitely was looking for moral victory. All we heard in the handshake line was what happened to 40.
Nobody was upset about the laws. They were more so just, hey, yo, I said they thought it was 40. I thought it was 40.
I give Kel a hard time for that to this day. Like, it wasn't good enough.
I got you, man. But y'all guys, y'all gonna light the city up a lot more this year. The competition is only going to get better. Y'all definitely got better. You haven't stopped working. The coaching got better. The kids
Which
got better.
What competition you talking about?
Damn, bro. He's ready to go. You know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about the national thing, the battle, the city, period, man. I know y'all guys about to make some crazy moves, man, and y'all about to do some special things. So, again, anytime I get a chance to sit down with y'all, man, get a little in-depth, more information on the team, I love it. Because, like I said, y'all my favorite guys. Y'all my favorite team. So, I definitely can't wait to film some games, to get a chance to watch y'all, see some new shit y'all got going on, see how y'all got better, see how y'all progress from the battle stage. And, again, man, y'all, a shout-out to y'all, man. Congrats on this MOTEP bid y'all got coming up. I wish y'all the best of luck in that, man. Y'all definitely going to do some great things, and just that's only going to make y'all better as coaches. You know what I mean? So, again, man, this is another episode of the Prolific Podcast. I got my guys here, future MOTEP coaches, the AD at TEP, my guy Rock, and the Pressure Pack, man. You know what I mean? I holler at y'all, man. Appreciate y'all checking us out. But we coming back. We going to keep rolling. We going to keep stumping on y'all. Prolific Podcast, we out of here.
I'm prolific, so gifted. I'm the type that's going to go.